When integrating services with Oracle's Integration Cloud Service, there are two main steps you need to complete. First, you need to create a connection, then you need to integrate those connections. For each connection, I will add a contact, configure the connectivity by specifying a WSDL URL, and then secure the connection by adding credentials. To configure the integration, I need to configure the source, the target, and then map the business objects to each other. Let's start by creating the RightNow connection. I'll select the RightNow adapter from the list and add basic information about the connection. I'll add the email address of the person who's going to act as the contact administrator. Next, I'll add the URL to the WSDL that allows Integration Cloud Service to find my RightNow instance. Because my application is password protected, I'll add the credentials required to access it. Now I'll test the connection. The test completes successfully, so I can save and exit the canvas. The new RightNow connection is shown at the top of the connections list. Now I'll repeat the process, this time configuring for the Oracle Sales Cloud connection. The new Sales Cloud connection is shown at the top of the connections list. Now that the connections are in place, I can create the integration. This is the list of existing integrations, but I'm going to create a new one. Since I have created both source and target connections, I'm going to map the data between them. Now I'll enter basic information about the integration. Note that new integrations can be added to new or existing packages, but I won't add this integration to a package. For more information about using packages, go to the online help or view the video entitled Using Packages in Oracle Integration Cloud Service at docs.oracle.com. On the integration canvas, I'll configure the RightNow connection as my source. The connection configuration wizard opens and I can add basic information about my connection. Now I can configure how to process the request. Because I want to receive organization objects in the request, I'll select organization from the list. Then I'll move on to the response. Because this is a one-way flow and there is no response, I'll select none. I can review a summary of my selections, and then I'm done. Now that it's configured, the canvas shows the RightNow instance and its inbound flow. Now I'll configure the target using the Oracle Sales Cloud connection that I created. Like I did for the source, I'll fill in the basic information. This time I'll select the Account Service service because I'm creating accounts in Oracle Sales Cloud. I'll also be sure that the Create Account operation is selected. That's all I need to do for this connection. Before I go any further, I'll save the integration. Now that both the source and target applications are in place, I can map the data to be shared between the two. The source data structure is on the left of the mapper, and the target data structure is on the right. To map the two fields to each other, I'll drag the name field from the source to the organization name field in the target. The green checkmark and the line connecting them indicate that these fields have been mapped. Because I have a large data structure, I'll use the search feature to locate the next fields to map. Now I'll drag the number of employees field over the employees total field to map them. Finally, I'll search for the currency field and map currency name with currency code. I'll save my work and exit the mapper. Now I'll configure a business identifier. This identifier enables me to use the monitor dashboard to track the associated payload field in messages during runtime. One business identifier is required as the primary business identifier, but I can define as many as three. Now that the request is mapped, the mapper icon is green and the progress meter is at 100%. I'll save and exit the canvas and then activate the integration. To activate the integration, I'll click the Activate button. The status is now active and the integration is complete.